the ideas about this is the result of a giant project, because this is actually a design review in progress. That's the entire team working on it.
The dog doing most of the work.
Rethinking what it means to make a really simple computer. So start off with a RAM and a NAND gate. There's the RAM at the top. Two parameters get fetched out of that RAM, two bits, put through the NAND gate and written back into the RAM. Now, if you keep on doing this with different addresses and destinations, you can obviously do anything that is possible to do with a computer. Not especially quickly, it's completely serial. So the RAM's working very every clock, and so is the NAND gate. So its efficiency is quite high, but speediness is not one of its properties. So we can soup it up a bit, give it a LUT3 instead of the NAND gate, and then it's many times quicker. We're just doing those three fetches out of RAM, three arbitrary addresses, writing it back into an arbitrary address. How do we make programs for this very simple machine? Don't have to do it by hand anymore. We can just use YOSIS, feed in some combinatorial Verilog. Out comes an enormous cascade of LUT3s. That is, in effect, the program for this tiny one-bit computer. There's no jumps, obviously. It's just a series of combinatorial operations. Well, that's very well. It's one bit. What's the point of all of this? You can build a giant SIMD array of these. It's been done in the past. CM1 is mostly forgotten now. They had 2 to the 16, 64K of these one-bit processors all operating in SIMD, all operating in lockstep. They all access the same place in RAM and write the destination to the same place in RAM. That's in the Computer History Museum. That's the CM1 there. That's connected with a lot of wires. Some ballpark numbers, just to finish up. Estimates in 45 nanometer. You could just about fit it on a 26 square millimeter die, so it's not crazy. That's 26 tera ops per second. That's 26 terabits being moved per second by the thing. And assuming you ran a floating point code on it, you get 17 gigaflops, which is okay, because it's software floating point. If you did anything else more exotic than floating point, you'd obviously get huge gains over traditional hardware. It's almost all SRAM. If you looked at the thing on the die, it would be all SRAM with a tiny bit of control logic and gate. So it's really an SRAM job. There are other details that I don't have time to talk about. That's it, one bit CPU.